Zdravo i dobrodošli u novu epizodu emisije Fancy Byte. Ovaj put startujemo sa novim konceptom koji će doneti još više vesti, intervjua i zanimljivih priloga, tako da smo sigurni da ćete uživati zajedno sa nama. Pogledajte šta vas očekuje u ovoj emisiji. Dosta toga se izdešavalo od posljednjeg izdanja naše emisije. Izašao je posljednji trailer za Sumrak sagu, emitovan je prvi promotivni video za novu sezonu Vampirskih dnevnika, a sada možemo da uživamo i u posterima likova iz ove serije. Evo vesti koje su obeležile prethodnih 7 dana.
Na nedavno održanoj dodeli MTV VMA nagrada, ekipa Sumrak sage je na dodeli predstavila poseban insert iz filma Praskozorije drugi deo u trajanju od 90 sekundi. Sam klip bio je najava posljednjeg trailera Sumrak sage ikada, koji je okačen 24 sata kasnije na sajtu Yahoo Movies. Klip su predstavili Taylor Lautner i Robert Pattinson zajedno sa još par glumaca iz ove franšize, ali bez glavne glumice. Kristen Stewart se nije pojavila na dodeli, ali smo je vidjeli dan kasnije u Torontu. Evo kako izgleda posljednji trailer Sumrak sage.
I've had a bad habit of underestimating you. Every obstacle you faced, I think you couldn't overcome it. And you just did.
I didn't expect you to seem so... you?
My time as a human was over. But I never felt more alive. I thought we would be safe forever. But forever isn't as long as I'd hoped.
I have to report a crime. The Collins, they've done something terrible.
The doctor thinks Renesmee is an immortal child.
She was born, not bitten. She grows every single day.
Oh my.
Creating an immortal child has long been outlawed and is met with the severest form of punishment. Death. What is it, Alice?
The Volturi. They're coming for us.
If enough people knew the truth, maybe we could convince the Volturi to listen.
Our search began looking for vampires in the most remote corners of the world.
My family's in danger. I need your help.
Each with their own gift.
You are an amazing woman. We'll join you.
Pax will fight. Never been afraid of vampires.
I'll never let anybody hurt you.
Kao što smo već pomenuli, Kristen Stewart se u subotu pojavila na premijeri svog novog filma Na putu u Torontu. U zanosnoj haljini Kristen je pozirala fotoreporterima na crvenom tepihu, davala intervjue i autograme svojim fanovima. Kako je to bilo i šta je mlada glumica tada izjavila, pogledajte u prilogu koji sledi.
How does this crowd compare to the crowds that you're used to? You know, you've shot in Canada several times now. How did you compare the crowds here?
Sweet. I don't know. There's really, I do kind of black out a little bit when I show up at places like this, and I've felt so welcomed, and I think it really matters when you're so proud. I'm so proud of this movie. I couldn't be more honest about that. So I couldn't stand taller. I think that everyone's probably pretty excited. It's so much bigger. I mean, on the road hasn't. Everyone who cares about this book has been waiting for forever to see it. So I think that. I think that's the most important thing.
It is a tough book to make. I think Walter did it though. I mean, I think the cut that everyone's seeing tonight feels like you're reading the novel.
She's fearless when it comes to this, and that's kind of can be a rarity.
Nakon više meseci čekanja, televizija DCW konačno je objavila prvi promo za premijeru nove sezone Vampirskih dnevnika. Nove scene doživjele su svoju premijeru, a kako to izgleda, pogledajte upravo sada.
You what?
Am I dead?
No.
She's still in transition. Not fully dead, not fully alive.
We have all day before she has to feed. That's a day to exhaust every possible way out of this.
There is no way out of it.
You feed or you die.
Fangs come in yet?
Maybe I can go to the other side and bring her back.
What kind of power is gonna let you kill yourself and bring someone back with you from the dead?
No matter what happens, I am here for you.
We're making our move.
You have no idea what you're up against.
Buddy!
Stefan, I'm dying.
The Vampire Diaries, season premiere, Thursday, October 11th at 8, 7 Central on the CW.
Nekoliko dana nakon emitovanja promotivnog video snimka, na internetu su se pojavile i promotivne fotografije likova iz Mystic Falls-a. Premijera nove sezone Vampirskih dnevnika se približila i ostalo je tačno mjesec dana do nje. Svi fanovi će moći da gledaju premijernu epizodu uživo na našem sajtu 12. oktobra, 2 sata posle ponoći. Ekskluzivna novost koju vam prenosimo je da ćemo to večer, 2 sata pre premijere, emitovati specijalnu emisiju uživo, povodom premijere nove sezone. Voditelji prvog srpskog TVD podcasta, zajedno sa još par gostiju, spremit će sve fanove za epizodu koja će mnoge ostaviti bez daha. Više informacija o emisiji očekuje vas uskoro na sajtu vampires.rs. Naše uzbuđenje povodom nove sezone Vampirskih dnevnika je ozbiljno poraslo kada smo saznali da će zvezda serije Tajni krug Phoebe Tonkin da se pridruži ekipi kao Hayley. Nismo saznali puno toga o misterioznoj lepotici, osim da je prijatelj Tylera, ali to se promijenilo nakon razgovora Phoebe Tonkin sa sajtom The Insider. Sviđa mi se što je svetski putnik, pomalo je muškobanjasta, samouverena i provokativna, ali ne onako kakva je Faye bila u Tajnom krugu, kaže Phoebe. Hayley nije imala roditeljske figure u svom životu, a ja volim takve osobe. Sviđa mi se to što je čvrsta i što pokušava da se drži sa momcima. Još jedan stanovnik Mystic Falls-a bez roditelja? Počinjemo da se pitamo šta je sa tim gradom i siročićima. Ali jedan deo intervjua sa Phoebe nas je razočarao. Nećemo vidjeti ni jednu scenu sa Hayley i Rebekom, jer njih dve još uvijek nisu snimile scenu. Mislim da su previše zabrinuti kako ćemo se smijati i opustiti na setu, kaže Phoebe.
Nina Dobre trenutno promoviše svoje posljednje filmsko ostvarenje, film The Perks of Being a Wallflower. Nedavno je bila u Torontu i tada je dala intervju koji možete upravo sada da pogledate.
Well, we're happy to have you back in Toronto. We all love you here. And you did such a wonderful job in this movie. And I want to know, you know, being a good Toronto girl, what was high school like for you?
I had a great high school experience. I went to a performing arts high school, so I, like my character in the movie, I was kind of, my mom was an artist, first of all, so she wanted me to take the art electives, and then I loved drama and dance and theater, and so that's what I was doing, and then my dad is like a book smart, kind of geeky type, so he was all about going to math and English and science, and so I had to kind of do a little bit of everything, and I always felt like I was torn in all these different directions. Mm-hmm. But it helped me discover what I loved, and that was the best school to do it. Wexford Collegiate is an incredible school, and so I had a great experience. Mind you, at the end I was working, so the last year I was kind of in and out intermittently. Yeah. But
it all worked out well for you.
It was all great, really, and I have nothing but the best memories.
Yeah. Why do you think Perks of a Wallflower just struck a chord with so many readers?
I think it's, you know what, it's a very timeless story and a timeless film, because despite the fact that it was in a way period, you know, whether those issues were 20 years ago, 10 years ago, or now, they're all kind of the same, and our problems transcend time. We all kind of go through the same things, and there's something that we relate to and that we remember from our own lives in each one of these characters, so I think that's why. Yeah. And it's not a sugar-coated Hollywood version. It feels like a real film and real people.
Exactly.
So
yeah, it is
I think
very
that's
real.
Why.
Bonding with this cast must have been incredible. Like, you're, all of you are so fantastic, and I understand that you all stayed in a hotel together, and must have been a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was cool. None of us were over 25, so we couldn't rent a car. So we were all kind of stuck in the same, in like the 5-block radius, and all they had was like Applebee's and a couple of local chain restaurants and the movie theater across the street. So kind of felt like you were back in high school where you didn't have a car, you didn't have all these other things to do, and it was great.
Yeah, and working with Logan, and you guys go way back because you were shooting the pilot of Vampire Diaries, and he was shooting Percy Jackson in Vancouver. So you guys have that connection.
Yeah, actually, Logan and I met initially because I almost got Percy Jackson. I tested for the main girl in that, so we met then, and then we saw each other in Vancouver, and like we constantly. Our paths cross all the time, and then we had the chance to finally work together, and I couldn't imagine anyone else in this role. He's so perfect and such a talented young actor. I can't wait to see him kind of explode more, even more so than he is now, and this film is gonna really do great things for him.
Yeah. Bila ovo još jedna emisija Fancy Bite. Vidimo se za 7 dana.